Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back. We are back in the game. Well, we're waiting for it to load at least. When this eventually loads. Last time we left off, I do believe we were. Where were we? Oh, about to find out, aren't we? Oh, we're back into. Oh, yes. Yes, yes, yes. We were crafting some spell books. And we went a little bit over time just to craft some extra ones that I didn't know about. And now we're looking to continue through the game, essentially. I need to get to enough of a level where I can finally get the last infusion from my incarnate. But, yeah, we're doing pretty well. We're doing pretty well. I apparently have to report something to you. What is it that I'm reporting to you? Let's have a look at the journal. Log. Alpha log. Waking Riker. Help Hanag. Demon. What am I stood in? Idiot. Deathrog Rising. Nope. Born in the family. Oh yeah, I need to speak to Tarquin. Ethin, oh, yep. Vida the hero, secreted away valuables. Oh, these are the hero's rest. Love has a price. One of us paid for love. Oh yeah. On the ropes. Murga has challenged us to win a fight blindfolded. Oh yeah, I've got to do that at some point.
Here I still am. Yes? Have you? In short, travel west in search of a dwarven base of operations in the Tretch should any such place exist.
Can't describe it to you any plainly than that.
Okay, I did travel west. I found said thing, and yes, but I don't know what else you actually want me to find. Oh, there's loads of stuff to loot, which I could be getting some really nice gear out of. Is that everything? Oh, I think so. Right. Well, on that note. Oh, I did want to collect something before I leave this place again. And I also need to make sure I collect his source points before I leave. I wanted to collect this chest. But I also want to know why you'd ever climb up there. But, you know, I'll find that out shortly. Some nails, thank you.
Boring.
And a picture of, okay, cool. Nothing interesting. Let's go find out why I would climb up here. And then I'll go make sure you're full of source points, Red Prince. I find it weird that his name's Red Prince. Like, surely he has a name. Read. Oh, I've already read that book, clearly. Go open the valve. I think that's everything. Cool. Yeah, I'm ignoring you for now. Nothing else to loot up here. I think I've read this already, but I don't know. So let's quickly read it. Nope. Cool. Right. I want to go back to the graveyard. I then want to go back over here, which is this way. I eventually want to go up this tower and deal with this situation, but I'm not going to do that yet.
Ah, you again. Any luck in old Lady Surrey's tomb?
He places his hand on the artifact, and it drones in its strange language. The object continues. Sarden menia veet feln, dom drisval veet evdekais.
It's true, then. Anathema within reach.
How very lovely that is true. This blade I'm never going to use in this game because it's two-handed.
Is this all there was? There weren't any other curios in there? Amazing, but not unexpected.
He breathes a long, lugubrious sigh.
It's time I leveled with you.
Thank you.
This is the hand grip of the fabled anathema. A sword capable of annihilating anyone. Even a divine.
Okay, that is pretty cool, I will admit. Let me turn my volume up a little bit.
Imagine it. Holding in your hand a force that could wipe away sun and shadow. A sword of life and death, miracle and sin. A sword of atonement.
Okay.
I can restore anathema to working condition, but this is only half of it. We still need the blade. How fortunate that the hilt has already told us where to find it. Blood Moon Island.
Blood Moon Island.
Well, you may not always have the smarts, but you've sure got the spirit.
Thank you, Tarquin.
Blood Moon Island awaits, my friend. It's a bit of a jaunt, but this gives me time to prepare my workspace. We'll catch up in the Lady Vengeance, yes?
Before we do, do you have anything I can buy from you? Not really. Oh, that's good. Do I have anything to sell to you? No, not really. No, I can sell you that. I can sell you Sovereign's Orbs. Well, loads of paper. Strange gem. Monstrous axe. There we go. I shall take that from you.
Tarquin doesn't wait for an answer. His attentions are already turned.
Okay, thank you, Tarquin. Can't do the thrice-bound chest. Let's go have a look at Garrett's buried valuables before we go speak to Riker. I don't think it matters which gate I leave, does it? Yeah, let's go. Let's go collect some valuables. Just one thing I need to double check. That's the one. Right, where am I actually looking over here? Up here somewhere? What's this? Oh, there it is. Go, Red Prince. Dig. Dig, man. Thank you. Flashing footsteps. Plus one pyrotechnic. Oh, they are awful. How are they so bad? Okay, thank you, I guess. It was kind of worthless to me, but thank you. Anyway. I don't want to go down there yet. Oh, hello, Victor Flynn.
It's true what the old miss told me. Victor, she said, you can't gamble forever. It's only a matter of time before your luck runs out. Bless her heart.
You're buried upside down.
The skeleton is old enough for flies to have eaten its flesh, though some of its owner's clothing still remains intact. The belt may have been gnawed by rodents and reptiles, but the name engraved on its buckle is unmistakable. Victor. The bones look properly intact, though its skull is askew, as if the skeleton is looking in a direction it shouldn't be able to.
So his neck was broken.
You see no blood or signs of struggle.
Well, here's one corpse that never got a proper burial.
The skeleton is old enough for flies to have eaten its flesh, though some of its owner's clothing still remains intact. You run your finger along the skull and spine until it finds a fissure. Upon closer inspection, you realize the victim suffered a broken neck. It seems this person took a great fall. The belt may have...
Well, you took a fall.
Never was good at...
Where did you fall from? I don't know. And you apparently we can all examine different things about this.
The skeleton is old enough for flies to have eaten its flesh. The earth beneath is slightly cratered. Either the skeleton's... The skeleton is old enough for flies... The earth...
Okay, you can all see the same thing. Okay, well, I can't do anything with you, apparently. At least I can't do anything yet that I can think of. Dead. Oh, I know what this fight is. Let's go.
Found
there we go.
The curtain drops. Your shadow.
No shadow can eclipse the spouse of the sun.
Delay your turn, Seville, because you can't see anything. Oh, there we go. There you are. Oh, okay. Let us make it rain. Wet, wet. You guys are wet, you're wet. Is there anyone that has really low magic armor? You two do. Right, first things first, are you suffocating? Yeah, but you're not dying sort of thing, so I'll heal you. I can't see you to heal you. Ah, okay. Well, on that case, soothing cold to beat back the suffering, the suffocating, because losing 53, gaining 60, perfect. Go for a bit of men metal to also do that. Nether swap. None of these guys. Poison? No, not really. Favorable wind. There we go. Oh, you're actually going to die, aren't you, Seville? You literally did die. Let's start by doing this. Swapping this surface area here. And putting it up here. That way I'm no longer suffering. Oh, I am, apparently. Okay. That feels a bit ridiculous. Let's make it burn. And does anyone have low enough? Yeah, you guys do. Sorry, Fane. But I don't want to get Seville in this. Oh, I did get Seville in it anyway. You just silenced Fane. Can I heal silence? Uh, And then you use chloroform vein. Oakley dokley, let us summon Mr. Incarnate. Let's use water. Let's pump him up. Use adrenaline. Pump him up some more. Pump him up some more. And can I get Seville? Yes. Heal Seville. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I'm now going to throw an orb at you and then battering ram you. Perfect. They don't have a lot. Am I going to get attacked? No, I'm not. Ooh, that took a... Oh, yes, I forgot about bloody ruptured tendons. Stab you in the back. Adrenaline. Flesh sacrifice. Oh, I'm so going to die. Rupture your tendons. Turn you into a chicken. First aid. And now go invisible. To avoid being hit again. Awesome. Yes. Damage back to you. Oh, I'm back visible again. Do I still have ruptured tendons? I do. That's kind of a bad thing. Well, I think on that note, I'm going to throw that and just be done with that. Oh, missed, thank God. Oh, going to hit with that one, though. And you're down. Okay. Seville is really easy to take down. Let's half steal myself. Oh, that's two. Oh. Never mind, I'm not gonna bother that. Is there any way? Yes, there is. At least this way they're burning so they can't go invisible. Really? You went up there to come back. Okay. And then you got punched. Nice job. You bloody silenced him again. What's the point? Thank you. Okay, hit the complete one that I didn't want you to hit. Heal you. How much does that do? That's quite good. And then have a throw at you. You're almost dead. Perfect. And then turn invisible. Because this thing needs to be invisible, apparently. You're silenced. So you literally can't do anything, but plink, dead. Plink. Dead. Okay, I actually killed more with Fane being invisible than anything else. Oh, archers are so painful in this game. That black... Oh, hang on. There you go. Have a bit of smoke cloud. See how you like it, not being able to see anything. You're almost dead. So let's add a bit of fire to it. Perfect. You are going to heal yourself. Thank you. and then summon some electricity totem up there. You're just going to throw, I think. And then end your turn. Eesh. Stunned. Can be cured by magic shell and bless. Armor of frost. Close. Get up. Thank you. Teleport? What do you mean you're invisible? You're not visible. Teleport? No? Okay, fine. We shall play this the other way. No. Okay, Winter Blast you. Even if I can't see you, I can hit you with an area of effect. Oh, you're back. Nope, can't hit you with that. Let us get up there. Has that gone onto my second page? It has. Up we go. And now let's punch you to death. How much damage is it going to do? Oh, bloody nothing. How is that so bad? Based on your basic attack, which is what? What's my basic attack? Oh, that explains a lot more. Okay. Well, on that note, let us just atrophy you. Yes, got rid of your bloody bow. Now let's hit you with that. And hit you with this. Hit you with that, hit you with that, and hit you with this. There we go. House of Shadows assassins. No match for a prince of the House of War, of course. Where are all my spell scrolls? All. Why is my inventory so all over the place? I apparently got 17 of these. Okay. Sword. Here, please. Wait, where are their bodies? Oh, so all that and I didn't even get any loot. Oh well, I shall kill you next time. Let's go this way. I don't remember what is this way, but let's go this way.
I spotted something.
And I found something. Okay. And it was nothing. Even better. Love it. We are currently heading towards... Let's head towards Gareth, I think. I've done you. Can... Oh, I can't remove it. Okay. There's nothing on those weird islands, I don't think. Oh, tree trunk. Oh, I've already been there. Okay. Let's go speak to the dog. If I can click on it.
The dog keeps his distance, wary eyes sizing you up as his hackles rise.
You run away. Everyone here run away. All run from something. Like sticks. Balls? I understand. I run away from bad man. Very bad man. Man wanted to make me spider food.
Okay.
I know. I can sniff good and bad. Right or bad.
Okay, cool.
He paws a few tentative steps closer and sniffs all around you, nose wrinkling with concentration.
Smell a runaway inside you. Maybe the runaway not good, but you good.
Okay.
He bounds forwards and licks your face.
Thank you.
His breath stinks of graveyard clay and ancient bones. Immediately, you feel an allergic reaction developing on your cheek, hot red blotches spreading in an angry rash. The dog scurries away to sniff about the area, leaving you with his approval and an itchy face.
Thank you. Let me get rid of that. Awesome. Can I just walk over here? Yes, I can. Good. I don't have to do any...
Much better days.
Okay. Hi, Gareth. An axe ring. Yes, please. Hi, Gareth.
Gareth toils in monotony. Gareth freezes, then turns slowly towards you. His breaths are steady, his voice a monotone.
I'm digging my own parents' graves. You'll have to forgive me for not being first-rate company.
Gareth moves to continue his task, but his cadence falters. He pauses. Silence hangs, begging to be broken.
No, of course you didn't. Godwoken, I've seen Seeker's blood seeping into the sand. I waded through corpses on the deck of the Lady Vengeance. But when the lifeless eyes looking back at you are your own mother's, I just didn't know. I didn't know what darkness lied beyond pain.
Wonder who could have come for...
Now I do.
Wonder who could have done this. Reach out and comfort him. Sure.
Gareth shies away from you. His eyes pass over the half-filled graves, and he takes a shuddering breath.
Comfort! Even Lucian has none to spare. I've prayed to him, an endless litany. How many tears do I have to shed? How much must I lose for him to listen? No comfort, only recompense. Against Dallas's cronies, against the abomination that carry out their commands. The monks do the dirty work, and the whites keep their robes clean. Convenient, the monks that did it. They're still in the house, spreading their rancid smell. Paladins came to clean up the mess. In the name of Lucian, they say, and they seem to believe it.
Okay.
Gareth forcefully exhales and looks past you to the nearby house. You fear he might snap the shovel's handle in two.
Said that Lucian might be gone, but you're still there for him. Seekers too. Mirror's anger, it's time for revenge. Tell him his rage. Spirits here are troubled. Tell him to think carefully about his next step.
I've got no use for empty platitudes. Not for some possessed prankster chosen as the Seven's special pet.
You
Thank you.
You hear Gareth's pulse, galloping faster than a saddled mount. You've never heard such a thing before, but you suspect Gareth's heart is close to tearing.
If you want to help, then you find the craven wight that ordered their slaughter. Anyone that stands between you and truth, no matter the flag they fly or creed they follow, make them bleed!
What was his parents want for him? Channel issues were full acts on rage. The wise calm their fury. Hey!
His clenched jaw tightens further, and then, in an instant, Gareth's guard is broken. Tears well in his eyes. With every blink, a pearl of grief falls to his cheeks.
My parents. They did nothing to deserve this. They were good. Honest. More honest than me.
You have anything to say whilst I'm just talking to you? No, not really. Okay, thank you.
I'd give my own life to bring them back. I never got that last chance to tell them I love them. I never got to say goodbye. You're right. There's nothing more to be done here. Lucian, forgive me. And please, Godwoken, please.
Please forgive me too.
Why do you keep praying to the old god? I'm your new god, or I will be eventually. Stop praying to me. Just wait for him to disappear over the horizon. Okay, dig up his corpse. Thank you. Mama, it's hard to be stationed so far from you and Papa, but I believe I'm doing the right thing to protect us. I wanted to write you a message to stay safe. Don't trust any magisters that call by. Paladin should be safe enough. All my love, your son, Gareth. Lovely. And sneak in the thievery. That's what I wanted. I shall give that to you, Sabeel, so that when you steal things, you steal more things. And you're sneakier when you do it. Right. I feel kind of disgusting.
It's the Magister's property. Let them handle it.
The two paladins Gareth mentioned are arguing in front of the door to the modest farmstead. As they notice your arrival, they stop talking and look at you quizzically.
We're guarding this house. Wise to stay well back. There's a bunch of silent monks inside who've tasted blood today. Already killed in there, so they did.
They didn't kill anybody. The Magisters who controlled them did. You know Donna, she wouldn't hurt a fly. Not until they turned her.
But they did turn her. And now she's not Donna anymore. Get it through your head. The poor creature should be put down.
I love your armor.
No, wait! Surely, maybe someday they can be fixed. When all this source nonsense is over.
Maybe.
The paladin rolls his eyes and shakes his head as he turns to face you.
In any event, it's our business, not yours. You just stay well away from the door and you'll be perfectly safe. You can't do that. They were people who were loved. It's not right to butcher them like cattle.
Tell him to trust you. Silent monks aren't people anymore. They're puppets. Tell him to think about it. What would Donna wish for? Tell him of the silent monks you've met on your travel. What would Donna wish for?
You're right. Here, take the key. We'll leave you to it. I don't want to see Donna like that again. You'll remember her as she was, Jad. The real her.
Paladin William nods his thanks to you. And with a last sorrow-filled glance at the house, Paladin Jad turns to follow his companion away.
Awesome, thank you.
Fine.
And awesome. Oh, that is a beautiful shield. I think I know I'm going to give that to. Fane, what shield have you got? Constitution, 20 air resistance, retribution, 35 HP. Yeah, you can have that. And what shield have you got? Yours is spare. Okay, add to Wes. That's a nice upgrade for you. Hello.
The lumpen silent monk stands like a pillar of decaying flesh. So still it seems he is not even breathing. All of a sudden, like a bellows, he exhales a fetid gust right into your face. The stench of rot shrouds you, coating you in a way you fear will never truly be washed away.
Thank you.
He looks through your eyes with seeming disinterest as the life ebbs from his body, drop by drop, until he is gone and the flesh that housed him slumps to the ground.
Oh, wow. Okay. Oh, the level one, that's why. I was going to say, that's the easiest I've ever done it.
Emaciated of body and spirit, this silent monk stands straighter than the others. The remnants of military bearing clear in her posture. This must be Donna, the one spoken of by the paladins guarding the door. She gives no indication at all that she has heard you, save for a single tear dripping from one eye.
Oh. I don't... No, I'm not going to kill you. I don't think I can. I've never listened to that before. And I'm a murdering scumbag.
A spillage all over the floor.
Thank you, narrator. Are you being serious? Oh, what's open in the... Oh, nothing. Okay. And a helmet. That's a very nice helmet. That's a really nice helmet, which I am going to wear now. Thank you. Pyrotechnic summoning. Is this any good for you? 10:44. Nope. More stuff to loot.
The silent monk looks like she was only recently converted. Her face was clearly beautiful once, and the eyes looking at you are not yet the full fuligin black of other silent monks you have seen. One of her hands trembles. Twitching, it reaches out to you. Her hand is cold and smooth, like that of a porcelain doll. Jerkily, as if unused to movement, she strokes your hand gently and looks into your eyes. Her lips part, and her mouth moves. Did she whisper, "Save me," or "Slay"?
Oh.
Or did you only hear what you wanted to hear in the whispers of the wind? Slipping your hand free from hers, you back away and leave her standing there. Her arm remains outstretched, stroking, as if you were still right there.
Oh, I don't like this.
The monk hangs his head, as if looking down at his feet. A wretched gurgling noise issues from him. Staring down into his face, you realize you were staring into mutilation. He has no eyes, his empty sockets crawling with blood maggots. The gurgling sound comes from his stitched mouth, though no meaning can be understood.
Yeah, I'm going to put you out.
He doesn't resist in the least, merely slumps to the ground with one final gurgle.
Yeah, I've killed two of them. I'm not going to kill the other two because the other two actually seem like they want to be saved.
Gareth always choose the right path. Nothing we didn't see coming. We always knew Gareth was fated for greatness. As a boy, he'd leap through the fields with wooden sword in hand, slaying imaginary demons, protecting us from whatever evil he would dream up. We also knew that good men make enemies. We knew evil would come, and so it did. Not as a demon or as a witch, but as a man Gareth once knew as a friend. Jonathan.
He watched
eagerly as those shambling husks descended. It seemed like a game to him. Like theatre. We would never blame Gareth. The righteous always pay a price. May the Seven will it. He will always be the hero we know him to be. We always want to believe in each other. It's what separates us from the void.
Fair enough.
It's what makes our existence worthwhile. It's what we do next that defines us. We can respond with treachery, or we can rise above.
Hey, Asuli. I'm not bad. How are you doing? Say you'll do.
I trust that you will. Gareth did his duty. We felt it was only right that we did ours. The farm was always a safe.
Have you been at work today or no? I've literally.
And so we gave them one.
I literally came in like 5-10 minutes before the stream started. Monday to Friday is always work. Alright, fair enough. I've managed to get a day off tomorrow, but I'm doing D&D in the night, so I'm not streaming tomorrow. Which is. Yeah.
Our guests were usually frightened, shy, grateful. They never used their source, so the Voidwoken never came. The last one, though, she wasn't like the others. A lizard named Hanag. We housed her and fed her. Robes like a wizard's, voice like a queen's. Voidwoken appeared before long, and paladins after that. She clearly drew the Magister's attentions. Our fates were written. I never thought she meant to do us wrong. I don't blame her for fleeing to the
Gravesward.
I worry for her.
I need one, trust me. I feel like I'm going nuts already. The origins of Lucian. You're not going to give me crafting recipes, okay? Flame rune, you will. Nope, I've already got that one apparently. Broken loot. I'll take the ruby. Let's Sibyl, could you pick this lock? What are you playing at the moment, Suli? Or are you not? Picture. And finally, oh, 2 gold. Right, okay. Well, I'm going to leave you guys alive. Wait, what? Just finished Paladins with a friend, so nothing now. All right, okay. Did you have a good set of games? What am I doing? Oh, I'm done in here. I'm done in there. Let's see what's over there. Oh, Jonathan's gloves. Poison resistance. I'm not going to go down towards that villager. Some good, some bad, but not many bad games, I'm surprised. It's always nice when you don't get many bad games. I can't reach that yet. I'll do that later. I want to know what that says.
Time and the elements have left this grave marker illegible.
Where did I find... Oh, okay. Do you mind not dropping meteors on my head? Can you dig this up, please? Looking at all the ghosts here, there is. I've missed a lot. No, not really. I found... I went and found, what's his name? Garrick. Burying his parents, which I promptly dug up after he left. And then went and looted his parents' house. And after I finished looting, I had a chat with him. And then I had a choice of killing some silent monks, which was just sat there. But I spoke to them, and two of them seemed really nice, so I left them alive. The other two I just killed. One was out of mercy, one was out of spite. So, no, I haven't really actually gotten through much yet. Hello.
A man paces back and forth, puffing anxiously on a pipe. His face is creased with tiredness. The faint coppery hue of dried blood stains his hands. He sees you.
If you're looking for healing or the like, then you'd best look elsewhere. My plate is full for now.
The man chomps on the bit of his pipe, generating a small cloud of nervous smoke. Finally, he plucks it from his mouth.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember everything to do with this guy. All I remember is I need a scholar.
I'll do what I can for her, but I'll need to concentrate. And that...
He gestures with his pipe for you to leave.
This isn't someone with a broken leg who needs to be held still. This is serious and dangerous. I doubt you could help.
Hey, thank you for letting me in. Oh,
fine. You can help. Take this... Just be careful. It's clear she's a powerful sorcerer, but also whatever she was subjected to has warped her in body and mind. I have her locked up for good reason.
Right, I'm pretty sure I need a scholar, so let me have a look. You're just a mystic, your scholar, and your scholar. All my characters are just scholars. I'll start with Fane. Thank you. Remind me to loot this place. Flaws of Deceit. Ooh. Excuse me, what? Is that a book? Did you get any FFC? I arrived literally 5 minutes, 10 minutes before stream started. So I had no chance. But as it's my day off tomorrow, I'm going to stay up tonight. Get them on tonight before...
Ready to flee, if necessary.
Before tomorrow. And that way I've got them for Thursday.
Across the cellar, a shape bearing some resemblance to a woman lurches around to face you. It utters a marrow-curdling gurgle.
She senses us. Be calm and quiet. No sudden moves.
I
You're right. I hadn't noticed before. Couldn't get close enough. We have to help her. Maybe we can reverse whatever was done to her.
Agreed.
All right. We need her subdued, understand? Do whatever you can to weaken her. Just don't go too far or you might kill her.
Asuli, is this the really difficult fight that I'm just about to die from? Because I'm pretty sure it is. I'm not sure. It was either way too... It was way too easy for me. Oh, good. So it should be easy. Okay.
Another gurgle. Sharper, angrier. Then the sound of rapid footfalls rushing towards you.
Goodbye. Hello. Ow. So, Fane, do you want to, you know, leave the area? Get up there. Right, Fane, you are just going to be buffing. So hold off there for now and put some water down here. And then let us... Favourable wind as well. Your job is pure buff.
She's too strong. She must be weakened, or there is no way to help her.
You've got a lot of armor. You've got a lot of armor. Did you say this fight is easy? Because it doesn't look like it. Flesh sacrifice. Backstab. Rupture tendons. There's no point doing that, is there? I'm never going to get through it. Yeah, let's just rupture tendons. Why not? Do a bit of adrenaline. Let's do a bit of atrophy. Well, not if your group is only physical. Oh! I killed one? Okay. Goodbye. And end turn. Come on. How can you even see Los? Okay, sure. Bit of epidemic of fire. I did nothing to you. Didn't do anything to anyone. Grab a bit of that. You're doing nothing, apparently. And now, let us... Is there any blood on the floor? No, there isn't. Let's make it rain some blood. Then adrenaline. Then summon the incarnate here. Boost him with a bit of power infusion. And finally, let's boost him with Farsight. There we go. There we go. Oh, they're all going to gang up on him. Shall we play a game of see how long my incarnate can live? Let's go for a bit of men metal. Let's go for a bit of armor of frost. Oh no. Seething cold, sorry. Let us get down here. Put some uncanny evasion on my incarnate. There we go. Oh, are you going straight for Fane? Oh, no, you're not. Oh, yeah, you are. Oh, hello. Invisible. Disappear. Disappear, Sabeel, now. I don't appreciate that. So let's do that. And let's do that. That's another one dead. Oh, come on. You can live. You've got this, Fane. Here's another one dead. Okay, no, this fight is easy. Okay, I clearly misremember this. Apart from the fact that Fane's about to die. Healing spells and potions will do you damage. Does this count as a healing spell? Yes, apparently it does. Cool, good to know. You stay there. Oh. That ended the fight.
There's no time to waste. We have to see what was done to her.
Oh, yeah. You always forget about shields up.
The young woman lies still on the floor.
Right.
Breathing an uneven rasp. Swan's satchel of surgical tools lies nearby. Swan approaches, cradling his arm with a grimace of pain.
Those summons of hers broke my arm. I'll do what I can to help, but the rest is up to you. Tread carefully. One false move and she's dead.
Well, keep her steady, I would say.
Swan carefully holds her head steady with his one good arm.
Oh, that's probably not a good idea.
Something moves along her exposed lobe. It's a maggot of some kind.
Gently try and remove the maggot. Oh, he's got a broken arm and he's already trying to hold her steady, so I'm going to delicately...
The maggot is caught in the pinch of the tweezers and plucked off in a single, swift movement.
Didn't I just say delicately?
The woman's breathing has grown shallow as she hovers between life and death. Hope for the best.
You're seeing how I'm doing with this. Well, I'm probably going to kill her. I'm guessing I've already killed her if one thing goes wrong. Because I asked Swan to bloody hold her steady and I doubt that's worked very well. She's going to die anyway, so let's just slowly close up the wound.
You replace the extracted bone and bind it with copper hooks. Then you draw the scalp back in place and start stitching the incision shut. The woman's breathing grows stronger, more even. Color flushes her cheeks.
She's alive. You did it.
Oh.
I've never seen anything like that, not in 20 years.
I thought she was definitely going to die when it told me about his broken arm.
I'll tend to her here for a while. She shouldn't be moved yet. She'll want to thank you once she comes round, I'm sure.
Okay, thank you.
That miracle that she survived.
Well, people have two arms, so use one for holding. Very fair point. Very fair point. Dead man. Grain. Let's look for other things to loot in this place. Why are there no lights in this place? I don't know what I actually get from doing that. I got some XP.
That was damn fine work you pulled off there. Consider me in your debt. I'll keep an eye on her until
she can
fend for herself. If you find yourself in need of potions or healing, be sure to come to me. It's the least. Help yourself. Until next time, take care of yourself.
You have nothing. Good to know. Oh. 1256. That's worse. That's bad. That's worse. That's quite good. And it's got thievery. I'm going to go grab something to eat. All right. I'm starving myself, to be fair. Enjoy your food. Okay, that was a nice little quest. Didn't take very long. I found a wand. It's a good wand as well. And a carrot. Because you can't have wands without carrots, apparently. There's loads of stuff to loot. I just wish it was easier to see down here. Why did you not have more lights? Tomato sauce. No, thank you. I'm not even going to bother picking that up because it sits in my inventory for about 7 years. That's terrible, but... Okay. Awesome. Right, let's climb. Now let's loot everything in this house. What was that? Slime. Okay, thank you. Is there actually much to loot in this place? Not really. Okay, let's go. See if there's anything good around here. Oh, it's an oven. Ah! Hello.
It sounds like there's a battle unfolding nearby.
I think that landscape is wrong. Well, let's have a look up there to see if there's any loot in here. I want to be able to get closer. Nope. Okay, cool. Right, where do I want to go next? I've got a mission up here, which is Diana. Oh yeah, her. This one is Jahan, last seen here. Anag. Ethi the Librarian. Or, yeah, let's go to Ethi the Librarian. Oh, yeah, I am in the right place. Over here, please. Where be you at, Ethi? Come on. I've got a book for you.
Not long to go now, I'm sure of it. Do you have it? Found the little corpse-related book I seek yet?
Do you have the item that I seek? Or anything that I seek, actually, for that matter. The fourth moon is pretty good. Got some live wood logs. Am I able to steal from you? Yeah, I've already pickpocketed you.
She stares at you blankly, empty sockets seeming to stretch into the farthest reaches of oblivion.
You do not know the question. I am already dead. My body is an anomaly. Splendid.
Where's corpse locate? Corpse explosion. There it is.
My thanks for your help.
A washer up, Max. Do you want to sell me some stuff? What's that discount? 28% discount. Okay. Is there any here I want to buy? Saw one the fourth moon, but I don't need it. Let's just let her die.
Thanks for your help. Perhaps we will meet again in the Hall of Echoes someday. I'm just going to find a place to rest. A place.
Are you going anywhere interesting, or are you just going to teleport in a second? I'm guessing you're about to teleport, aren't you? Maybe you're not. Maybe you're actually going to go do something. Oh, no, you teleported. I'm like, hello, Sulu. What have you got in yourself?
Nothing better than being your own boss in life.
Meat pies and beer. Oh. That actually sounds wicked. I'm going to order myself some pizza later, I think, because I've had nothing to eat all day. But meat pies and beer. Oh, what toppings do I like? To be honest, it depends what I feel like. I like a lot of meat type stuff, so sausages, bacon, pepperoni, barbecue sauce. I like that on top of it, like instead of tomato sauce. Gotta have some cheese. But my favourite one at the moment is spicy sausage, jalapeno, and black olive with a barbecue base.
And there's something in it.
10,000 masks of cowardice, each and every one of them. He'll carve them all, one by slowly one into your quivering.
Yeah, barbecue base. Instead of tomato base, you get a barbecue base.
He will. But one day, his one true name I'll know. And so undo him.
Hello, Mordekaine.
Nothing good will come of speaking with them. They may sound merely mad, but they're infinitely more clever than you imagine. They move between moods like wind through trees, only to settle upon the one that may just sway you.
Fair enough. I do enjoy it. It's the one I've got at the moment. I've got a little pizza shop. Literally like 5 minutes down the road from where I live, and it currently does buy one get one free, so you can, and it's only like 14 quid for a like big pizza. I think it's 18 inch pizza or something like that. I don't remember off the top of my head. And you can just get another one for free, so you can just get two different pizzas for free. The only problem is I can't buy one without getting the other one for free. So I'm just going to end up fat soon. Or fatter soon. I can't justify it. I just want to buy pizza all the time.
They'll talk themselves out of that cage if you let them.
I know, right? They've been doing it for ages.
Before you know it.
And it's not even like... it's not even like... They've only just opened, so they're doing a deal whilst they're opening. They've just been doing it for ages.
I have an offer, if you'll hear it. There's a great deal I could show you regarding the power within you. A great deal of potential I could unlock. But there's something I need to...
Cheaper. Well, it's like maybe 2 quid cheaper per pizza. but because you're getting that free one, it's literally half price. So, yeah, it's just, and it's a really nice pizza place. Huge ratings. It's all clean. It's amazing. And one of the best things is when you order a pizza, they cook it in front of you. Like, they've got a big pizza oven that's open to display, and they cook it in front of you whilst you're ordering it. So it's just awesome. Duca Cheaper, and they make a second one too. How the fuck do they? I know. I don't know. I literally don't know. Like, I've got genuinely no idea. I'm guessing they're supported by someone with a bigger company or something like that. I don't know.
I will teach you, of course, but only if you do me a little favor first.
Yeah, they might put something in it that you don't know about.
Quid pro quo, I'm afraid. A tad vulgar of me, that much I admit, but needs must when the demon drives. I've a demon of my own, you see. One I've been hunting for a long time, and now I've managed to track him down to the island over yonder.
He points towards the northeast. You see nothing in that direction but grey water and a thick mist in which ghoulish shapes seem to form and fade.
Thank you.
I know it's there. My caged guests have confirmed as much. But to my great frustration, I cannot reach my goal. Death fog surrounds the island, and through death fog, even I.
Seems like every town has its own price point. Where around. Come in. You can see it in its size. Yeah. Yeah, that's how it usually is. Like, for example, if you go, I don't know, Pizza Hut versus Frankie and Benny's and things like that, and you always get those like differences in prices and size. But this pizza place is odd. I don't understand why it's cheaper, and I also don't understand why they're giving you a free one. Like, again, if it was like a freshly opened pizza place, I understand a little bit, but it's been there for like a year and a half, 2 years. But pizza is one of the best things. That and pasta. Pizza and pasta. To my dismay, because pizza and pasta make me fat.
Of course, you are but a mortal for now, but you are godwoken as well. Surely you have a few tricks up your sleeve.
Yes, I plan to walk over the bridge.
Consider it a test. Kill the demon, and I will be your teacher. Like I said, we'll speak of this after the lesson. First, I need you to prove you have it in you to slay one of these horrors.
Pizza and pasta makes you fat if you don't consume those calories. Well, yeah, I guess. If I
shake your hand and describe your target.
If I don't eat anything else, I might be able to eat pizza. But yeah, I'm also gluten intolerant. Oh well, any food makes you fat if you don't do anything. That's also a very good point. Very, very good point.
The demon's guise, or vessel, one can't be quite certain, is that of a lizard known only as the Advocate.
About a year ago, gluten intolerant, yeah, and lactose intolerant. I'm a failure of a human specimen. Like, gluten and lactose intolerant. I couldn't be much worse. Hang on, what was I saying? Yeah, about a year ago, I weighed like 5 stone more than I do now. Like, I was proper bad. But I sort of just stopped eating crap and did a little bit of exercise, and I lost it all within like a year. It was really good. But I've sort of plateaued since then. So I haven't been able to lose much more weight up before, after that point.
Like all of his ilk, he is kind. He is charming. He will offer you what you desire most at seemingly no cost at all.
Stones is in stones and pounds. So don't ask me to calculate that because I have absolutely no idea. But very funny. And if you make a joke about pounds being the UK currency, yes. Also very funny.
There is no such thing as no cost at all.
What do you weigh things in? What sort of stone? Granite? The weighing kind. I'm sorry I use a weird measurement system. I live in the UK. We use both, all right? We use both the imperial and the metric system because we like to be different to everyone.
My advice is to strike before he even has a chance to speak. But should you choose to disregard me, should you allow him to parley, all you have to do is say no.
We use this neat SI system called grams. You weigh things in grams? Well, yeah, but what if it's really heavy? You don't want to be weighing things in millions or billions of grams, do you? I guess you could go kilograms. Yeah, fair enough. I just answered my own question, and yes, I'm an idiot. Yes, yes, I'm an idiot. Okay.
Above all else, remember that.
We weigh most things in grams, to be fair. We weigh literally everything in grams, kilograms, and tons. Until it comes to the human body, in which we name thing, we weigh things in pounds. As soon as it's the human body, it's all pounds. I don't know why, but it is. So if you're interested.
He smiles, like one would at a child, asking about the birds and the bees.
I know, because I've known others like you.
Those what's wrong with you? Oh, wait, you're a Brit.
Chained for better or for worse to that of the gods themselves.
Exactly. We're messed up in the head. We do things everything the long way round. We measure some things and some things in other things. Like, yeah, we're just wrong in every way.
I have battled the foe of foes and conquered it. I have sat in perfumed gardens with the source herself, drank life from her very lips. I have seen well over 2,000 springs and will continue to do so until time itself closes its weary eyes.
Are you immortal, sir?
Trust me. I know what you are. May you want...
Okay, thank you. I can't go into your house, though, can I? I really want to. Everyone come inside. Come on. Pick this lock. You're the god of gods, but I'll tell you something. I can still steal from you super easily. Fortunately, you can't see through windows for some reason. Hello, I'm back. Ignore the fact that I stole everything from you.
Maybe the river could be crossed on that.
Thank you. Squirrel. Chase the squirrel. You use grams and stuff, then you use pounds and stones. What about length or speed? It depends. With length, if you're measuring, like, I don't know, a road, you would use miles. How many miles is this road? Or a distance between two things, you choose miles. But if you're measuring, like, the size of a field or a house, you'd use meters and kilometers. And then speed, we mainly just use miles per hour. I don't think I've ever seen anyone. Oh, no. Public transport, so trains and things, they use kilometres. Would you stop running?
Don't be casting your long shadows around here, missy.
Oh, you didn't even have anything decent to say. So, yeah, so trains use kilometres an hour. Cars use miles per hour. Yeah. It's not complex, it's stupid. Hello, Furno.
I'd give up my wings for a respite from this pestilence.
How do I cure diseased? First aid?
My feathers are molting. My wings can't carry me anymore. I feel so cold. All I can think about is warmth.
It painstakingly attempts to flap its spindly wings, failing
miserably.
I doubt anything can remedy how terrible I feel.
How do I... Do you know anything about this, Isuli? This chicken? Burno. I remember he gives you the phoenix egg, but I can't remember what I have to do. Yeah, pure stupid. What about pressure, pascals, or bars? Oh, God. Pressure. Don't remember what... I don't think I've seen that chicken. Pascals or bars? Hang on. Which one was pounds per square inch? Is that pascal or bar? Well, it also depends. If you're talking about a weather... We use, oh god, I can't remember which one's which now. If you're talking about, like, the pressure of a tyre, you use pounds per square inch. I don't know whether that's pascals or bars. But I think with weather, we talk about pressure in the opposite version. I just can't remember what it is, because I haven't watched the Weather Channel in about a million years.
What have I done?
I'm just going to kill you. Fine. Goodbye. Oh. That's pascals. Because we use bars. Oh! I got a phoenix egg. Okay. What? So pounds per square inch is pascals. What is bars? Like, what's one of their measurements?
But not from the ashes. This warmth comes from deep within the egg. The egg is smooth and glossy dark, like some rare volcanic mineral. From deep within its core, a fiery glow pulsates, almost like a heartbeat.
I didn't even know you could do this, by the way. I just tried to kill it.
A phoenix egg is a priceless treasure. It should be cared for.
This creature is born of fire. Eat it. And you might gain some of its power.
It seems like a rare find indeed. You would be wise to preserve it.
Let us preserve it.
If this little egg can make it, well, maybe we can too. I'm going to keep it safe.
Awesome. I didn't know I could do that. There's a lost purse down here. So one bar is 10 newtons. Wait, is that 10 newtons? One centimeter cubed. Yes. Yeah, we do use that. So if we're measuring, pressure in a tire, so air, we use pounds per square inch. If we're measuring fluid pressure, like water and like a liquid pressure, we will do newtons. We use literally everything. Like 1 centimeter squared, not cubed.
Talk to whomever I like.
1 centimeter squared, not cubed. You use everything. Try to remember which you use and what. This is the problem, because we use them at such random intervals. Like, I know what a kilometer is, and I know what a mile is, but if you were to ask me to transfer one to the other, I would never be able to do it. Like, ever. I know a kilometer is 1,000 meters, but I don't know how many meters are in a mile. It's something like 1,200 or 973 or something stupid. So you get these weird scenarios where we're sat using two different measurement schemes. 1,600 meters in a mile. See? How did you know that? Or did you research it?
I know they're still here. My apologies for my idiot friend. But we could really use your help. You won't believe it. She won't believe it, Mabel. She'll think we're mad cows. Truth is, kind miss, that we are not, in fact, cows. At least not such.
We are talkers, people in some third world countries still use miles. Yes, thank you. I agree with that completely. I think that's amazing that you're taught that stuff, because we're not even taught like how to convert it, really. We're just taught in certain scenarios you use one thing and in other scenarios you use another. Like, if someone was to walk up to me, like, let's say they're from America and go, oh, what's 200 kilometers per hour in miles per hour? I'd sit there and go, I don't know. Like, it's that sort of thing. I would never know how to, translate it.
We're people. Captives, to be exact. Enslaved by the witch. You're not here to visit Alice Elysium.
We're taught only length, so kilometres and miles, centimetres to inches, and feet too. That's another good point, right? If you're measuring height, yeah, you sometimes measure in feet and inches, and then if you're ever having like a medical exam, they'll measure you in centimetres. Why? Yeah, I've got no idea. Like, so a while ago I had a medical and they asked me my height, so I was like, oh, I'm 6 foot, and they turned around and went, no, in centimeters please. Like, I don't know what 6 foot is in centimeters. There you go. I think I'm 182 or 83 centimeters. I'm 6 foot one specifically. Actually, let me try and figure this out before you tell me. So what is 180 divided by 6? That would be divided by 2, and it's 90. I wish I could do this better than I'm doing it right now.
I can think of a few ways.
Is it something like 30, 60, 90? Yeah. 30. Yeah, 30. 30. So, oh, wait. No, I've got to figure out an inch. Well, 1 foot is 30 centimeters. There are 12 inches in a foot, so you divide that by 12, which is something like 3 centimeters, a little bit less than that. It's about like 2.4, so I'm about 182-ish, 183-ish. Just let me know how badly I did that. Like 182.4, I'm guessing, for 6 foot 1 inch. Probably incorrect. Wait, I actually did that. Or are you just taking the mic?
Just get us something to drink. What my friend here means to say, kind lady, is that there's a cure for our condition.
Hey!
Alice Elysion has it in her house. If we could drink it, we could regain our former forms, as it were, and steal away.
So I managed to get down to 30 centimeters is a foot. And then when I realized I had to divide it by 12, I just divided by 10 and then took a little bit off the top. I didn't work it out exactly.
Don't mention the rats. For God's sake, Geraldine. What rats?
Maths. I'm good at it. Or I was.
Just ordinary rats. Nothing special or awful about them at all.
Oh, okay. Quick math. Yeah, literally, math. That's the type of mathematics I do. Just math. Oh. Spirit of a squashed traveller.
The spirit doesn't register your presence at all.
Should have paid. Should have paid.
Oh, you didn't pay. Well, serves you right. Right. You said meth. Hey, teleporty. No. Not quite meth. More math. Let's go to the witch's house. Oh, what does this say? How you doing, teleporty?
Here be witchery. Trespass not.
Why is that said in such a stupid way? Good, good to hear.
Oh my gods, you're ugly. You turn milk green and a magister's red coat black. My mistress Alice might fancy you, though.
Felt good wasting all your books yesterday. Didn't waste them, although I haven't used them yet because I don't have enough memory slots.
The magisters with the red coats chased her into the woods. They'll be so...
How do I get in this place? It's locked. Do I have the key already?
Fasten tight.
Nope. Sabeel, open. Thank you.
Smells of lavender and charred flesh. It's almost homely. Almost.
Bly Garrick. Oh. Okay, never mind. Wait, what was that? Treated like cattle. You clearly want talking to.
Hello. Stand back a bit there. I'm not feeling very well. I'm really not well.
Oh, you're not going to change anything. Okay. Ancient human skull. Paper. Keep calm and carry on. Keep calm, carry on. With the full book, we can summon Duna's Undertaker with sauce-infused mutton and appease it with a specific ritual. The book contains the location of the altar. Oh, I already know where the altar is. I'll take the book then. Thank you. I didn't realise I had to get the book from here. Oh, there's a witch eye here. Right, let's head downstairs. Oh. Sabeel. Thank you. Oh, if I remember this, this was... a right arse of a quest.
I'm really not well.
I said not to worry about the rats.
I never knew Brits are that. Well, yeah, we are. We are really messed up. Now you know why we're so miserable all the time. We never know which way's up. Right. Is there a way to do this quest without dying constantly? Um, that and it there.
Rats.
Oh, no, that didn't work. Oh, quickly, before more come. Yes, it does rain here always. Yes. Does it not rain in Finland that much? I thought it would. what am I doing? To be fair, the rain isn't that bad. I quite like the rain, personally. Well, in full, yeah, not. You guys have seasons? What is this thing you call seasons? We have season. Singular. I don't even know how to do this. Your turn. It's cold, not so cold, maybe warm. Cold, not so cold, maybe warm, a little bit colder. And oh, that actually really made me laugh. Thank you for that. Welcome to Finland. Now, I preferred your original. Can you not kill me today, please? Wait, you can destroy those. Yeah? I noticed that they had health, so I decided I'd just destroy them. I don't think it stops the rats, though, because I'm still dying. Are there any more holes? What does this switch do? Just took my tank and ran through. Well, I was going to do that, but then I almost died, so I decided it wasn't as good as an idea. Ow, you moron. There we go. Oh, you're still alive. Oh, moved. There we go. They're all dead. Right. Jump you down from there. And get you all healed up. That was not fun. That proper wrecked me. Voidwoken Spike. Intelligence Potion. I could do with one of those. Tea Herbs, Mortar and Pestle. Yevlin. Right. Spider Leg. Witch's Potion.
Good find.
Can't you craft one? I thought you could. I just can't remember how.
You won't take it off me. You won't take it off me. The book. Atlas's book. You won't take it off me.
Will I not? Thank you. The witches, you understand the elements. Oh, I need a scholar to read it because apparently I'm an idiot. Read. What? Oh, do I need a scholar and a mystic? Please tell me I have a scholar and a mystic. Oh, you legend, Fane. You are a legend.
It's so gratifying when all my hours of arcane studies pay off.
How do I make this potion? Potion. Witch's brew potion. I need a witch's eye, Argamendor, and Botellus, whatever that said. And I shall craft two. I've already got one. Remember the first time I killed this thing, I left it too far away and I couldn't reach it. And I didn't have teleport at the time. So, oh, there's a rat here. Nah, okay. Alright, let's head upstairs. Or, unless this guy's got anything on him. Nope. Get the eye, you need it. I think it's up here, isn't it? Yeah, it's here.
Is that her eye? Did she pluck out her own eye?
Oh, it's in the frog, is it? There's two. Ooh. No, this is just a normal eye. I needed a witch's eye. Yeah. You made me come back downstairs. witch's brew potion. Combine. Oh, I've got two of them. Let us go. I've got two. I picked up one. Oh. They're slightly different, which makes me very slightly worried. We shall find out what they do shortly. When I either successfully pass this quest or fail it. Thank you for that input. Cool. All right, let's speak to these bovines.
Please help us. Oh, I only need one. Geraldine, that's great news. One each. These will take effect any moment now. I can't thank you enough. Thank you. Is that thanks enough? My potion's starting to work, Mabel.
Here we go.
Oh, never see another that's again. Better. It'll be too soon.
Wait, what?
Glad to see you. You still have my gratitude. Thanks for keeping quiet about, you know.
Do you have anything to loot?
Goodbye again.
You've got a lot of gold. Ooh. You've got so much stuff on you.
I like this place. It's nice.
Can someone talk to him?
Oh, hi. Nice to see you.
Hello, Geraldine. And you drive the wrong side of the road. No. As the person that as the people that invented cars, I think, I don't know if that's actually true, that might be very incorrect, so I'm going to stop whilst I'm ahead. It might have been the Germans that invented cars. They like inventing things like that. Sabil, do you want to just leave, please? You go over here.
That'll teach you to make us...
But there's a reason why we drive on that side of the road. It's a very valid reason. Sabil needs a new set. A set of what? Armor set? I upgraded her armor set. Oh, yeah, I know the Vulture armor. Yeah, I know. I know what you're saying, but why does most of the world switch to the other side? Because it's better. It might be better, but we're stubborn. And yeah, I'm trying to build the Vulture set at the moment. That's my main goal. Sort of. It's sort of my main goal. I need to somehow make some source meat. Source infused meat. I need some raw mutton. Where the hell do I get mutton from? I'm guessing I might get mutton from this guy. But you... Oh, it's with the... it's fish guy. Okay, fish guy. But we're stuck in our ways as Brits, by the way, Asuli. Once we do something one way, we'll do it that way forever. It's why nothing has changed in our education, our parliament. Nothing. We are the same as we were about 1,000 years ago. And boy, I wish it would change. But it won't.
Well, hello, stranger.
Mutton.
Interested in Driftwood's finest catch?
No, I'm not interested in your finest catch. Thank you. Continue.
You look down at the cart and see fish with...
Have it your way.
Thank you. Right. Oh, that's really good. Shame it's two-handed. G, recipes, source, search. Thank you. Combine. Got some sauce-infused meat. Let's, on that note, also actually get some sauce. Would people move out the bloody way? Thank you. Bye, Siva. Nice to see you again. Oh, you left that one pyramid here. Yeah, it's what I do, so I can jump back and forth. If I know I'm going into a battle, I'll drop my red pyramid on the floor, teleport to the blue one, then teleport back. Speaking of which... okay. Gotta use that next time I play. What? The pyramids? Or are you talking about the infused, the vulture armor? Because if you haven't used... Wait. You haven't used the pyramids before? In that way? Yeah, by the time you've got four, you have so many. You may as well leave at least like one at a source point. Just bamf back and forth. Like, you can be in a massive battle, just waste your sauce just to finish it quicker, and then bamf back, go grab some sauce, and go again. I don't know actually what I'm supposed to... Just put the gift bag one. Wait, there's a gift bag one? I'll wait till I'm actually here before I look at it. I never use rally. Uh-oh, I never really use that much sauce. Yeah, but once you know you've got infinite amounts of sauce... You just use it for everything. That's why I'm not bothered about using source points. Gift bag. Which gift bag one were you on about? 9 lives. No. Plant. Your own herb garden. Nope. Oh, what? The source point whenever a character rests. Yeah. That one's alright. But, I don't know. Because you can rest, like... Yeah, I guess. I might as well. Yeah. Never underestimate the... Resurrect your dead allies. Maybe if you were doing another playthrough. I've got animal empathy on. I was tempted to put combat randomizer on. When entering combat, one or more enemies will receive the new special statuses created for this modification. This will... Should I turn this on? Because I'm having a fairly easy time of it. Oh, it's broken. Okay, I'm not going to turn that on then. Improved organization. No. Pet power. Ooh. Pet power enhances the summoning class. Since when does the summoning class need enhancement? Okay. Cool. Right, what am I actually doing? I'm putting the source meat on this platform, apparently. Oh.
So do you call on his undertaker? The death that feasts.
You look big. And you're level 15. Did you go to... Oh, I didn't. Oh my god. I don't even know if I've still got his bloody eye. Oh, I hope I haven't sold his eye. I haven't. Okay. Remind me to do that after I do this, Azuli. I can't forget. Also, this thing is scary.
Every falling feather judges your heart.
Hello.
Act with honor or be consumed.
Wait, you've got to choose the right ones. You're kidding me. No, I don't want to lose the armor. Well, obviously not reach for your weapon. I guess humbled? These two sound over the top. Let's go humbled.
The beast emits a sharp growl. It lowers its head, angling its beak into a cruel smile.
I can devour the living just the same.
Okay, I think I failed. Yep. I'm not going to win this fight. I am far too low level. Well. When was my last save? Just so I know how far back I'm going to go. Can I actually win this fight in any manner at all? I don't think I actually can. Teleporty, seeing so you remember this, if I run from this, do you know if I fail it completely? Or can I come back to this? Or do I just have to reload? Because I can't win this fight. And if I die, I think I'm just going to be sent. You never fought it. Oh, good. Thank you. Bastards. Right, let's give it a go. Right, who am I playing as? I'm playing as Fane. Who has the lowest magic armor? 330, 825. Walk away with one. Yes, fights are too easy, Azuli. And then this. It's level 15. Return. I'm so gonna lose this. Goodbye, Lois. Oh no, Sibyl's gonna die. Oh no, Sibyl actually survived that. Only because Thingamabobber, but you know. Only because her Tyrant's Charm. So she's probably gonna die before she gets a go. That was fun. I don't know why you only have 3 points. Oh, that's because of that. Let's use a bit of adrenaline. Oh, that's only one. Let's go for some fire. Why not? Get some of this. Get some of this. Get some of this. Right, you should immediately get another go. You do. You only get one AP. Why do it? Oh, because... Yeah, I was just talking about that. So what are you on at the moment? 429, 434. Let's blood infuse... curse blood infuse you. That's a little bit better. Does it affect steam? Clouds. I refuse to run. Is there anyone that's about to die? Stood near me. One of them is knocked down. I will fight this to the bitter end. Because if there's a chance I can win it, I will do it. Even if I have to spam the revive scroll. Oh, Sabil's dead. Oh! Okay. Yep. All beans. All beans. I am not playing dead teleportee. I should, but I will not. Let's move to here. Fortify. Armor of Frost. Restoration. Attack of Opportunity. Wait, I'm alive again? Oh, my main character's alive. Okay, sure. Wait, I used Restoration on Fair. Oh, for God's sake. Right, okay. cool. I will win this fight. I don't know what you're saying. I'm not winning this fight. Is there even anyone I can remotely touch? Oh, you. Oh, I did have Idol of Rebirth, didn't I? Yeah. Well, I got him down to half health. Help! There we go. I didn't get a chance to run there. Well, I did. I have plenty of chances to run, but... my previous load is literally as I'm talking to this thing. Oh, God. Do you think they were a little bit high level for me? I get a feeling they were just a tad more powerful than I was. Yeah. Depends on what level you are. I'm level 12. They were level 15 and 14. Oh, you are kidding me. I can't even run.
Healing.
Oh my god. I don't even know how I'm supposed to... There we go. Yeah, hurry up and kill me, please. Yeah, that's the build, Dad. They killed me faster this time, to be fair. I'm impressed by that. Can you hurry up and kill my main? Stop buffing your guys. Oh. Oh, you had to cut. Oh. Alright, come on then. The bloody Ashen Idol of Rebirth. I'm just gonna load this. Hang on. I can't bother to wait till I die. Right, I've got to try all the options, as you were saying, Asuli. The dialogues are, 1, receive the blessings, 3, bow with arms outstretched, 4, quietly request blessings. How did we get from 4 to 2? Oh. Oh, right. It's not 4 as in that, it's option 4. I want to fight him. I want to fight them, though. I do want to fight him. I just don't want to die. I'm going to do a test. Right. Everyone else, run. Go on. Off you go. Now, I'm going to see if I can just die. Thank you. That would have actually been a better shout, wouldn't it? If I'd left someone with adrenaline. I'm blind now as well. How do I do this? Let's just run. Yes. Oh, I'm stunned. Yeah, I should have left Sabile to do it. Oh no, I couldn't leave Sabile because I was the one that was talking and I don't have adrenaline. There we go. And I'm back. Then just die, I guess. I do get what you mean, though. Yeah, come on. Hurry up. Right, there we go. So you are going to stay. So how am I going to do this? Ah. Can you stop sneaking and just run? Now sneak. Can I reach my main from here? Oh my god, I can. Right, this is fine, I think. Run away! Oh! I'm alive! Okay, that was the worst thing I have ever done in this game, ever. I I'm a pro gamer, guys. I am actually disappointed in myself. I've never felt as disappointed in myself as I do right now. I hope you both know that. I need to level up. How do I level up in this place? I'll go speak to Dianya, see if she'll give me a level. Look how close I am to leveling up as well. Who are you guys?
The couple notice you approach.
Greetings.
Greetings.
The open road. And a new life at the end of it, hopefully.
Fulton, our business is our business.
Yeah.
Remember what Carl Van told us.
The man nods. Chase.
We don't know where we're going, but we're definitely not going back. There's no reason for anyone to go back where we came from unless they have a death wish.
Yeah, they do seem like good XP, teleporty. It'd help if I'm able to kill them first, though.
We heard that our homes are likely gone. Voidwoken. We'd be dead with everyone there if we weren't forced to meet and see. Fulton's a sorcerer. I don't care about that. I love him. But too many people from where we come from would care.
Okay.
Yeah, they were just stuck in their ways. Afraid of what's being said about people like me.
Well, they're all dead now. And they can't stop us being
lovely.
Together.
Is there anything good in the waterfall? Oh, come on, you're telling me there's nothing behind the waterfall? Okay, fine. Oh, there's a chest over here, though. Watch me walk through these mines or something. Oh, no, I didn't. Don't know where I'm going. What level are you guys before I arrive? Level 14. Yeah, let's not go near the level 14 thing, please.
Four deer.
Oh, for
formation near
Christ on a bike.
Three stags, fawn-coloured and hearty.
I didn't even come anywhere close to you.
Black skeleton, glowing an eerie green.
Now.
No.
Now.
The three fawn-coloured stags shake their antlers. The clouds.
He's level 14.
Huh?
What? Where are we?
You. Vermin, always treading where you are least wanted. Enough.
Okay. I've got them on my side. They're all, what, level 14 as well. Okay, I should be able to win this. Maybe not, actually, because they seem pretty terrible. You know your initiative's bad when four deer go in front of you.
Prepare yourself.
What can cure decaying? Nothing. Okay, cool. Good to know. I'll just fortify cure it, okay. I'll remember that for next time. Let me just move Sabil 11.7 meters and not use a single AP point. I love that. Thank you, Sabil. And then backstab. Then rupture tendons. Then adrenaline. Then chicken. And then away. End turn. Knocked down. Stabbed. stabbed. Oh. Hey, you guys are about as good as I am. Don't think you can actually do anything. No. I'm just gonna... Can you throw that far? Oh, they're so close to being dead. Guys, I think I can kill this chicken. Just about. I don't feel completely useless. And dead. Just about kill the chicken. Are you gonna be alright, dear? Oh yeah, you're fine. I got sauce up.
Is it really dead?
Oh dear, what that happened.
Where my thinker nut used to be. If you hadn't come when you did, I might be like that thing.
The table might give me XP. Okay, I'll have a look.
You came when you did.
I don't mean to fawn, but without you,
Fawn.
I don't know. I feel like I could eat a whole bloody cow.
What are you going to say?
The stag nuzzles you. Its soft, downy snout pressed into your side.
Snuggle friend. Donkey. On the
The ancient altar before which the deer crowded sits stark in the dappled forest light. Something about it draws you in. It seems to emit a faint, pleasing heat.
That deer is amazing. Oh, so an ancient altar that emits some strange heat and looks like it has blood on it. Let's lay down on it.
Heat warms your hand.
Oh.
The stones appear to be... The air stirs, as though someone had appeared and taken a seat upon the altar. A voice rises around you, its source unclear. Fractured whispers surround you. God woken. The word flutters against your ear. You are my...
Not champion. Look at my horse, look at my you deer.
Fail. A jolting sensation pierces your heart. As the shock fades, you realize you've absorbed a modicum of source, seemingly from the air around you. The whispers shuffle away.
No, it didn't give me any XP. You lied to me, teleporter. You lied. You didn't, but you did. Okay, cool. Right, let's carry on. I don't actually know where I'm going. Let's stop here. Have I been up here yet? Apparently I've been up here. I don't remember being up here. Oh, this is the lone wolf encampment.
Go no further. We are at ritual. Do not disturb us.
Thank you.
Enter there. Keep respect.
Someone is definitely hidden in that bush. Driftwood is weird in the sense you don't know 100% sure where you are, where you should be going. Yeah, exactly. You just did. Yeah, I've just met them. I am genuinely terrible with Driftwood. I never know... where I'm going. Comrade,
they're chanting low and
blood to earth, to wood, to birth. The blood of Sarius to this earth.
You know, not this Sarius. Offer a prayer to Tyrs and Dulus. Whisper the refrain.
The tallest, strongest elf, whom you take to be the leader, gives you a sidelong... She sure. Places the tip of a long-bladed spear on poor dead Sarius's chest bone.
Wait. Oh, am I supposed to be waiting? I won't do anything else. I feel like I've already messed something up. Mordor's cellar.
Blood.
Her companions reach out and grasp the spear, ready to plunge it into
blood.
Together you plunge the blade deep into Sarius's
blood to blood.
Each warrior plucks a piece of heart and places it in their mouth. Chewing slowly, their leader looks to you to see what you will do.
Surely.
Sarius's memories flood you. A warrior, proud and true, you fight the lone wolves at the Sawmill.
Where's the healer?
Your scion, and for the future of all the elves.
Oh no, she's inside the encampment.
Still remain. But the fight, you and Tova draw fire, that your friends may flee. You die in Tova's arms. With the barest blink, Tova accepts your good wishes, then turns back to the corpse.
Why are you talking,
Sarius is a warrior,
Sibyl?
Proud and true. Blood to blood, earth to earth, wood to wood, birth to birth. Sarius becomes his tree. May Sarius take root.
The elves pick Sarius's bloody corpse from the...
Do they? Okay, I'll have to buy from them shortly. Or steal from them, should I say.
Tova looks to you. Then, after a moment's thought, indicates for you to help.
Hey!
You send Sarius to his final resting place. His corpse rolls to a stop at the bottom of the pit. The elven leader stands and stares at her fallen comrade. Then she wipes away a tear.
Awesome. I don't know what I did, but awesome. Oh, not what I meant to press. Oh, where are you going? No, come back. Don't go do stuff stupidly. Right, before I do anything else, I need to go do Mordus's chamber. Mordus's chamber, Mordus's chamber, come on. I've never been down into Mordus's chamber. It's down here, right? Sully? There was a skull. Oh, yeah. I'm guessing it opens up somewhere, something up here due to the map. Ah, there we go. There we go. Right. Okay, that makes sense, I think. So let's break up my people, because I'm guessing they've got to stand in different positions anyway. What happens if I stand there? You do those four. Do I get you to stand here, maybe? That turns them both to fire. But then how do I get these? So would I go there? Put Fane there, see what I get. Get fire here, I don't want fire here. I also get fire here. What about there? That's getting closer to what I want. What? Maybe I'll just put this guy here. Spiel, you jump off. That turns them both to water. If I then put this guy here, that turns them both to fire, which is what I want. Do I need another object? Move you over to here. No. Asuli, just give me one hint. Do I need a fifth object for this before I lose my mind? Yes, okay, cool. I thought so, but I wasn't sure. I bet you the fifth object goes here. Maybe. Shift this to... Oh, there. And then to there, did I say? What happens if I then stand here? Fire, fire, fire. There. So you're in the wrong place then. What happens if I go there? No. Wrong place. Okay. I'm going to be perfectly honest with you, Asuli. I didn't mean to. That was an accident. I was actually clicking the wrong place. Oh, lovely. Poke. Poke. Neither did I. I had Sir Laura help me. Where is Sir Laura? I haven't seen him in a while. I know he's dead, but I haven't seen, like, you know. Okay. Desiccated undead. Just in the right place at the right time. Poke. Poke. I don't like this place, Asuli. Got to admit. This quest is fun and grim, I've got to say. Yeah. Grubby tone. I feel like I've actually got to read this. The Undead Among Us, author Midimhex, Chapter 7, The Lich. These manipulative creatures are unique among undead, not because they command source. Many rekindled souls draw from their own inner well, after all. But because it flows from an apparently everlasting wellspring into their bones and hollows. Several manners of a harvesting lich supply source are known, though... Okay. I didn't need to read that. That was relatively point. What? Right, what? What am I doing? Okay, cool. I guess I'm killing stuff. Oh! Did I try and look into the vase and they were sat there? Fair enough, I guess. You've got very little. Yeah. I've apparently got 6 AP again. It happens on occasion. I'm never sure why. Sorry, Red Prince. Knock you down. And then get rid of your armor as well. How far can you go? Why can't you go up there? Oh, I can attack you. Oh, no, I can't. Can I attack anyone else? You just wasted CC. That was atrophied already. Oh, yeah. I didn't really think about that. Boop. Flesh sacrifice. Rupture tendons. Adrenaline. Chicken. Phoenix dive. Backstab. And I missed. I missed. Of course I did. Because what would it be without me missing? God damn it. Oh, you're over there. What are you doing? Well, you're quite powerful, aren't you? Welcome to XCOM Original Sins. Oh, you know what? I'm going to add that to my list. XCOM. I've got to play that at some point. I love XCOM. It's great. Have you ever played XCOM? I'm guessing you have, by the fact that you know all the references. Let's put you there. XCOM was fantastic. Irritating as hell, but fantastic. Fireball. Who did you hit? Not many people, really. Did you play the Bureau? No, I've never even heard of that before. What is it? Well, I'm guessing it's an XCOM game. So ask a stupid question, get a stupid answer, but I've never heard of it before. XCOM meets Mass Effect. Oh, that sounds wicked. That actually sounds... Was it actually any good? Or when I inevitably play this game, will I be disappointed? Bureau XCOM declassified. XCOM declassified. Add that to my list. power infusion. Adrenaline. Tell you what, having adrenaline on your summoner is so good. Farsight. Oh, you've still got something else you can do. Yeah, just do that. Why not? Oh, wow. 233 points of damage. Nice. Nah, you're burning. Oh, Sabeel actually survived a hit. And now you're atrophied. Gameplay was solid. Story I like. Just the gameplay or anything wasn't good as Mass Effect, so it took a little bit off. I'd recommend, though. You know what? Yeah. It's pretty low down on the long list I've got. But I will do it. As it's come from an Asuli own recommendation. I love killing people by healing them. Yeah, I'll have to play that. That sounds like a good game. But my list is getting longer and I haven't even finished two games yet. Right, who am I killing today? Oh, I can't hit you. Okay. Let's move to here. Oh, I brought you a friend, Incarnate. There he is. Now that was not called for. Where are you going? You're hiding. Okay. Fair enough. Unfortunately for you, dear friend, you cannot hide what you cannot outrun. Oh, you're still alive. Yeah, I guess I would be as well. Make that two friends. Do you have any magic armor left? Can I reach you at all? Can't reach you at all. Let's try. Oh, come on. I can't. Okay, never mind. That'd have been nice. Zap. And heal. Oh, you're actually healing yourself. Hold on. Oh, you're healing yourself twice. What did you just curse? Cast? Oh. You summoned this guy. Okay. I'll just prod you a little bit. Spin round, kill everything. You're dead. You're dead. And you should be dead. Oh. Why'd you move, Sabeel? Oh.
Be wary. The urns will shatter. The bones will rise.
The glowing corpse looks to you. The erratic rising and falling of its sternum is accompanied by melodramatic gurgle.
Come. Come to me.
The creature groans.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm not going to talk to you at all just yet. Oh. Really, Fane? Where are you? There we go. Also, why am I even controlling you? Thank you. Good find. Now, that fight was absolutely easy. Identify. Yes, please. I shall have those. Disciples' leg armor. Their level 11 is... Oh, yeah, they were only a level 11. I didn't even look. Don't ruin it for me. Just tell me that I'm good. That's what I demand from you. Please. Large masterwork rune. Nothing of interest there. Nothing of interest there. Nice old sorsorb. Throw my shield at this. No, nothing. What's that over there causing that light? You asked the wrong guy. Nah, I'm more fond of the idea of just being called terrible. I know what I am. I don't deny it. Thank you. My game just froze a little bit there. That was weird. Poke. Okay, what do you want?
You see an undead figure chained to a torture rack, bones glowing a sickly green, as if...
Please! Release me!
Feel like I shouldn't do this. He's asking nicely. But he's also a lich. Asuli, is this guy a bad guy? Am I going to regret releasing him?
Mordus, the priest. Not what he claims to be.
Okay. Thank you, Asuli.
He doesn't draw on his own strength, his own source. With this contraption, he draws upon mine. Free, free me. Release me from Mordus' torture.
Thanks.
The panel, please.
The skeleton ekes out a crackling moan.
The panel. Seven bless you.
Which button is it, though? I don't know what button it is to let you free, man. There's four of them. I'm going to go read his journal again. I feel like I missed something in his journal. No, I didn't miss anything. Asuli, I think I missed something. Which button is it to actually free him?
I long for...
Because I haven't seen anything or heard anything that describes what button I need to press. Oh, thank you. Broad skull. Oh, something to loot. Yeah, nothing in it. That is probably one of the worst things I've actually seen in this game so far. Green is released. Okay.
What's on your mind?
I don't want to talk to you. Green button.
Freedom! About time, too! I can't tell you how long Mordus has been draining me. I'm absolutely famished for sauce and sauce.
sinew.
Creature harumphs.
You free the master of the magical arts. For that, I'll leave you alive and untasted. For demolishing Mordus's minions, I'll give you a skill book of your choice. Choose subject.
How about Necro Geo Pyro Rogomancy? I like that one. But I'm going to get him to teach me.
I offer you life and learning, and you're still begging for more?
Oh.
You're wasting my time. Here, just take a book. Its wisdom might do you some good. Speaking of which, allow me to share some wisdom of my own.
The undead creature bears...
Man, you're level 11. Crated teeth. I will destroy you.
Stay out of my way.
Okay.
Curse you, Mortis, and curse your blasted machine.
Okay. Well... Let's go kill a lich, I guess.
The creature begged for release, but can it be trusted?
It looks like we've unleashed some chaos. Well, a little more on top of that can't.
He who wakes an ancient evil must slay said ancient evil. If that's not an expression, it should be.
I agree, Red Prince.
I say we hunt it down. Sometimes it's fun to play the hero.
That's slightly too realistic, Sabeel.
Perhaps it would be wise to follow it. People can do terrible things when freed, even accidentally.
Sabeel, can you open these boxes? Thank you. Oh, that one's already open. Wicked. Unidentified helmet. Unidentified that. The helmet is terrible. What's in this box? Nothing. Okay, cool. Well, that loot was terrible. Let's go kill a lich. Can't wait to kill a lich. Or I might end up dying trying to kill a lich. I don't yet know. Terrible equals sellable. Exactly. Exactly. Always the optimist. Where am I going to find this lich? Oh! Yeah. Oh no, I did this, didn't I? We'll take that potion though. That's just going to be up here, if anything. Where can I find a lich? No, get over yourself, everyone. Now then, do you want to come along? What is wrong with you all? Get over yourself. Right. I found him. Oh, it didn't take me very long, did it?
The creature devours the corpses as a vulture devours carrion, stopping only as you approach.
I have my freedom. You have your reward. Do you not recall my warning? He drained me. Let me feed. Oh, I cannot control the hunger. Mordus.
All right. Yeah.
I... away his hide, and he
yes, I killed him.
His lifeblood. Now, my hunger must be sated.
Ask if it was fair. Yeah, I'll give you.
Look at you, all noble. I can't promise that your sacrifice will fill my belly.
It reaches out with its brittle fingers, and you hesitantly offer your hand. In an instant that feels like an eon, your source flows into the famished creature.
Oh, refreshed and refilled. Oh, you won't need to worry about your precious innocence anymore. Join me at my reliquary. I will take my soul. You will take what remains.
Did I just make another mistake? Oh, God's sake, idiot. Why did I think that was going to work? Something that will get me killed. Yep. Where am I going? Lich. If you think not fighting is a mistake, then yeah. Okay, so I'm going to end up fighting him. Cool. Let's kill him. He's only a level 11. I doubt it's going to be that difficult, is it? Speaking of which, before we enter this fight, how about I actually rest up my party? Hello.
The creature rubs its clattering hands together.
It's about time. My soul...
No, hang on, let me... Okay, never mind. Oh, you don't have anything on you. I was going to pickpocket a lich. Right. You're saying I'm going to have to fight this, so let's get ready to fight. Make it rain? It depends on what I choose. Sure. Oh, no, I wanted to fight him. How do I fight him? Oh, too far away. Okay. I won't fight him then. That felt a bit naff. I feel like I did something wrong there. Meh, oh well, I guess. There's no wrong. Okay, good. That is the worst thing I've heard ever. But there's no wrong answer with that, yeah? Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Oh, well, there is, but you didn't get it, thankfully. Oh, okay. Right, now let me go back to the Diania place. There. The Elven camp. Okay, well, at least I didn't get the bad result. I did want to fight him, though, to be fair. Because it gives more XP, usually, when you fight stuff in this game. And I really need to level up, because I need to be able to do more stuff. I feel very hemmed in and all over the place, because I can't do certain things in certain areas. So I have to keep going back and forth. My battery on my phone is literally dead. Okay. Oh.
The tree-form spirit slowly, oh so slowly, becomes aware of you. When he speaks, it's low and slow. He grumbles, as if in discomfort or in pain.
I see you. A lone wolf took my life as I tried to take hers. She fought the battle well, at least as well as I. The mill ran red with blood. Much of it was mine. No, not at all. This pain right now is from taking root. This pain is good. This pain is life.
Okay.
Talk your way inside. Talk gently and tell lies, or creep and crawl. There is a way, a secret way. Fight if fight you must, but do not dare to hope to kill them all. But if you can, please kill them all.
With a last great creaking groan, he returns to the business of securing his roots.
Okay.
I see you. Worry not. The wound tells the eye a lie. In truth, the pain is not so bad. The lone wolf in the mill, who cuts me so, has luck upon his side. For now, not so our own dear Sarius. If his tree may grow, perhaps he may find rest. The shaman knows about these things, not I. Tova is up.
I heal you. Apparently not, okay.
I see you.
The shaman searches your eyes for a sign that you might be lying.
You speak the truth. Your news is good. Many trees are lost to the death fog, and the ritual does not always work. This is not a well of souls, but a simple pit. We stand ritual more in hope than faith.
Oh, you sell stuff. Sorry, I know what you're saying is probably important, but you sell stuff. That rings quite good. Yeah, most of it's naff, though.
A single tear appears at the corner of one eye. But he ignores it.
We may yet live on, we elves. I see the good in you. I see the bad in you. I see the all of you.
Thank you.
I see you and I fear you not. Injured I may be. Do not take me for vulnerable.
Wasn't planning on it, but okay. Do you have anything that I can steal or sell or buy? No.
I fight. I do not win, and I do not die. It is this way from the moment we left our homeland. From the moment the mists of death descend. We fight for our lives as we fight all our lives. We fight the black ring on the side of the divine. But Lucian betrays us. Lucian sends us to our deaths. And so we fight. And fight again. And fight until the moment where we find our home once more.
Note that home is where the heart is, a nation is a people. Misery over there.
Our losses are many and painful. And so we fight, that our victory may be great.
Okay, thank you.
The tall elf stares into the pit with dry, bloodshot eyes, her face betraying no emotion.
I fight.
Sneaking movement. Your gear is terrible. I thought this gear was good.
We lose too much. We lose our homes. We lose our safety. We lose each other.
Continue.
She looks into your eyes, her face set in a fierce frown.
It is enough. No more.
Yield or not, I fight.
Taylor, this is a...
I do not doubt it. The void is too close. It pulls us all toward it. If we do not hold fast, we disappear inside it. You honor us during the ritual. You honor Sarius.
Oh, thank you.
You help remember him. You help bury him. But we need help still, or we perish here. I wonder if you honor us once more. It is something of great importance to me and to my people. Our home forests are gone. The great trees are cut to pieces. The memories inside them nearly lost. Okay. They become nothingness unless we find our Sion. She is...
Her voice catches in her throat.
She is my daughter.
Yay, Sahelia.
And she is taken from us. That is why we come here. That is why we lose Sarius, to find her. If she is lost, if our Sion is lost, all our people are lost. She is everything.
Her eyes narrow, her fists clench, and her mouth tightens to a thin line.
Do you know the lone wolves?
Yep.
Yes. Savage is just right. They care for gold, not life. Sahela is taken to Fort Joy, and the wolves steal her from there.
Okay, so she escaped.
She is calm. She sees so much. Too much for one so young. We come here to get her back. To bring her home. She is everything to me. She is everything to us. You do. You speak to her. Then you understand. You see what a gentle soul she is. You see how kind. She is not only a Sion, but a precious child. Cannot be lost. You honor us. I feel
no worries.
It is impossible for one of my kind to enter their base. They know we are here. They expect us.
Well, if they're level 12 or below, I'll kill them all.
She is taken by their leader, a savage man named Roost Anlon. I do not know why, but I know she must return to me. If I lose her, I cannot lose her. We plan another assault. We cannot give up. It is better for us all to die than for... I only hope perhaps you find her before then. Good luck.
Okay, right. Let's see what level they are. Guessing this is the front entrance he told me not to enter into. So let's not go there. There's a way around the side here, and there's the chest. Let's go around the side. I don't see any reason as to not go around the side instead of going through the front. So let's just do that. Oh, and you've got this place. Thank you for talking.
Yes. We have to find the masters. As such, my first priority remains to find Roost.
Oh yeah, that's who we're going to see. I'll speak to you guys in a minute, because I know what you do, but I just leveled up. Do you need more slots? You're okay. This was a tough fight. Yeah, I know. I'm sort of ignoring it at the moment. I could go for demon. What's my current fire resistance? Oh. Bugger all. Do you need extra slots? No, you don't. You've actually got a spare slot at the moment. Torturer. Oh, yes. Yes, very good point. Very good point. Torturer. Chink. What do you need? I can give you bigger and better. Doesn't affect melee skills. That's a bit pointless for me. I might go for Morning Person for Sabeel, the amount of time she dies. What's stench? Stench decreases, but melee opponents find you less attractive in combat. That's almost tempting. Ruptured tendons isn't blocked anyway, so I don't know why it's even got that there. I'm going to leave that for now. I'm going to go for mnemonic for you. Mnemonic. Oh, I've already got mnemonic. Okay. Ruptured tendons is blocked by... Is it? I've never been blocked by physical armor with it. And it doesn't say it there. Look, I'll try it. So I'm no way... Yeah, it doesn't get blocked by physical. I like how I just stabbed my own character to test that. I'm going to leave that for now. I want more stuff on you. Is there anything... What is living armor? No, that's pointless. What stench? Unstable, walk it off. What a rush. Do you not have anything that's going to give you extra... Bigger and better. Let's give you bigger and better. And let's give you mnemonic. Do you need mnemonic? Yeah, you're going to need mnemonic. Walk it off is good. Yeah, but it also includes positive statuses. And I don't like that. I don't want positive statuses to be disappearing. Let's go mnemonic for you. I then want some extra constitution and some extra summon. I then want extra healing, magic armor, like fortify, armor of frost, restoration, soothing cold, mend metal, haste, invisible, everything, essentially. Let's put you up to 5 on the geomancer, and then I've got 4 to spend here. I could just pump it into intelligence, couldn't I? Let's give you 1 more wits, and then all into intelligence. You, I'm going to give you a little bit more in wits, and then another point in finesse. Let's go another point in scoundrel, do I think? Yeah, let's go for another point in scoundrel. I just don't know what is really good for Sabeel, to be fair. I think Morning Person would be really good, because Sabeel seems to die every 5 seconds. So to be able to resurrect her at full would be nice. Or I could go for Parry Master to give me a 10% chance to dodge. What is my current chance to dodge? Dodging, 17. So that'd be a quarter of all attacks against Sabeel will be dodged. Yeah. So that's actually a good point. That's actually a really good point. I don't think Walk It Off would be good at all, because she's never alive long enough to do any of it. I'll leave it for now. You're going to go for... another point into warfare. And I think just more constitution. Yeah. There we go. Right. Let's quickly venture this direction. Axe in the woods. Sure, I shall have axe in the woods. There's also a backpack down here. Right. Is that death fog? It doesn't look like death fog. Is it death fog? It is death fog. Okay, don't want to go too far over there then. What's down this way? Oh, this is just the entrance. Never mind. Back up here I go. What's over here? Ah, sneaky. Also, have you been to the fishery downstairs in Driftwood? Yes, yes, I've been in there. Rocky River Frog.
These river guys will shoot you through if you get...
Yeah, where you find the source weapons and get attacked by everything under the sun. Yeah, I did that. Did that. I didn't really understand most of it. Ooh. Yeah, you've been there. That is really good. But it's too high on finesse for me. But I think I know who it is good for. Well, have I had the wrong gloves on you this entire time? I literally have. But I think these ones are better. Yeah, just a little bit. I never use shocking touch, so... Are these better than what I've got on? 1250. Yes. I might as well put them on myself. I'll lose first aid, but I'll get shocking touch, apparently. Right, you are at least wearing the right belt. Oh, I thought that was a bloody shrieker for a second.
I suspect these skulls were left here as a warning.
Really, main character?
Don't expect a welcome.
Oh my god, I didn't ever think that they might be left there as a warning. You are so smart. There's nothing up there. Okay, cool. Oh, squirrel.
My mate for nerd wants an adversary.
Oh, you died.
On mommy dearest's trunk chest thing. It was never the same after that. I guess losing half your face does something to a guy. Or so my mum says.
My mate, Bernard, once nabbed a seed that had fallen on mummy dearest trunk chest thing. He was never the same after that. I guess losing half your face. I went to the end of the Reaper's Coast. There, just before Blood Moon Island. What? Here, Asuli? Or to the underneath of the fishery? And you've died here before, Teleporty. Was that during one of your honour runs? Because I couldn't imagine still wanting to play... Oh, here. I can't even remember what I did the last time I was here. No, your normal one. I was going to say, if I'd have gotten this far into the game and died, I'd have just stopped. Right, what level are these guys? Can I see anyone? I can hear someone. Oh, level 14. Level 15. Right, leaving this place. Cool. Can't even touch that fight. Oh, right. I hate it when I can't fight things. Guys, what else is there to fight on this map? That I can possibly kill. Your elf has a level. I know, I haven't chosen yet. Is Black Pits the right level though? Or is Black Pits also going to be too high? I genuinely don't know. I think it'll be level now. I'm just going to quickly kill this thing. Because it's already end of stream, really. But I'll quickly kill this thing if I can. And then next time we'll start with the black bits. Oh, it's another one of those altars. What is taking you so long? I also think I clicked way too close. No. If you can, exactly. What?
My lord. Help me.
He's level 14. Yeah. I guess it's the black pits then. Well, I'll teleport myself in front of it. Summon. And buff. No, there's no chance teleporting, because I know he summons a whole bunch of wolves to help him as well, and all the wolves have vampiric bloody touch. There's not a chance. It'll end up being the fight against that god again. Duna or whatever her face is. Where do I need to go? I need to go down to here, please. Right. I'll get down here. I'll save the game. Have you gone to the basement? What, the basement in this house? This house. Yes, I've been to the basement in this house and in the fishery. Yeah. I've dealt with that. I fought that battle. That battle was really easy. You're level 12. Let's have a quick look. What level is the enemies? Level 13. Ah, perfect level. Right, well, I'll save here. I'll actually back up a bit. There we go. Hang on. Yeah, I do find one of the biggest issues with DOS, especially when it comes to the Reaper's Coast, because it gives you so many directions but no real direction, you end up wandering around just trying to find things. Because I know full well if I go to this side of the map, I'll just die straight up. But it's so close to just here. So that's one of the things I do sort of... I wish there was a little bit more, like, I don't know, recommended level. Look at all this. What is my main character's elements? Fire, warfare, and that's it. Fire, warfare, and a little bit of polymorph. Then I've got Sibyl, who's a bit of pyrotechnic, a bit of warfare, and a bit of rogue. A bit of lightning for Fane, Geomancer, and Hydrofist. And then finally, Necromancer and Summoner. So my summoner essentially fills any gap that my team has. Be good. I just need some sort of recommended level. Like, don't go to this area unless you're like level 13. Otherwise, you're going to die. My team is good until I fight anything that's fire-based. And then I'm terrible teleporting. Trust me. It does get real bad as soon as you're fighting fire stuff. Right, anyway. So... I'm going to call, by the way, can I see your necromancer stats? Oh, no, you can see him. Let me flick back. Gameplay. Red Prince. So that's what I've gone for him at the moment. So he's got a 12 in strength with plus 2 from gear, 11 in finesse, 20 in intelligence. I'm probably going to drop his intelligence a little bit and put some more in constitution. 23 in memory, and then 10 in wits, because wits is pointless for him. I've then gone for nothing in Huntsman, that's just from gear. 1 in Hydrofist, so I can get Raining Blood. Constitution is not that important in this game. Is it not? I get hit all the time. Necromancer 3 with a plus 4 from gear, just to like 12 to wear shields. Yeah, I guess. But then again, none of the stats are that important, are they? Apart from memory and maybe wits. So, they're all as bad as each other if you sort of think about it. Anyway, pyrotechnic is at a 2. Scoundrel's at a 1. I can't remember why I've got scoundrel. Oh, yeah. If you're going to build a summoner / necromancer, always get 1 point in scoundrel so you can get adrenaline. Because it means you can summon your incarnate, which takes 2, and then you've got 4 of these infusions, and you can boost them all. So you've instantly got a fully boosted summon. That's the one thing I did find out. Also, never make your summoner an elf, because although you get the eat flesh ability, it minuses 3 constitution, which means you can't wear a shield. And then finally, I've got summoning base of 10, so I can get my incarnate champion. If you're going to make a summoner, the first thing you go for is summoning level 10. Like, boost that through the roof. I can use the blood for my summon, though. Exactly. Yeah, but you can use Bleeding Rain for that. Or, because my guy is so low wits, because he's so low wits, by the time it gets round to him, there will be blood on the floor anyway. So I just don't bother with that. I prefer him to have high constitution so he can take a hit. Then you've got Fane, who's here. He's just pure intelligence for his healing buffs, really, and a load of memory. Everything else is just base. He's a Theriotherge, Hydrophist, and now 5 in Geomancer. Yeah. Elf? Oh, as a summoner. Yeah, it's just the moment you minus 3 to your own constitution, it's so detrimental if you've not prepared for it. Like, you just end up ungearing everything. Shield, no. Was an archer, so OP. Yeah, elves as an archer, or as I'm finding out, a rogue, are brilliant. Because you don't need to wear a shield anyway, and you just get that extra 10% damage and an extra AP. One other thing for you. I would always go for at least one of your characters to be as high on the lucky charm as possible. Because any box you open, you can just get loot. Like, amazing loot. How many times, Asuli, have I opened fish barrels and found, like, ludicrous shields? In fact, the shield that he's wearing right now, I found in a fish barrel. Just found it. Or in a pile of fish or something like that. It was ridiculous. And then for Sabeel, I've got these stats here. I had my big one too. It's amazing stuff. Yeah, it's amazing. It's silly, this stuff you find. Sabeel is essentially all in Scoundrel, with a little bit of Polymorph and a little bit of Warfare. And a little bit of Pyrotechnic. The reason why I've gone all into Scoundrel is just that extra movement, and then she's got the Pawn ability, which means she can take an action's worth of movement without using an action. I wish this guy would shut up. Why are you fighting? I'd move some of the Scoundrel and put it into Warfare. Yeah, but I really like the extra movement you get. It's really good. And the critical multiplier, because the backstab always counts as a critical. Backlash always does critical damage. If I hit them from behind, I always get instant crit. Especially with Blitz, so I can hit 2 targets and get crits on both of them. It's so powerful. The only problem is she falls down so much, it's ridiculous. As in, dies. And then finally, my main, I've gone for Polymorph is at 5, Pyrotechnic is at 8, and I've got a bit of Warfare. The reason why I've gone for, you should give, that is a fantastic idea. Brilliant idea, Asuli. I don't know why I didn't think of that but that is fantastic. The reason why I've gone so much into Polymorph is because right at the end of the game, well, not even at the end of the game, when I get to the next level, I think, you get a ability called... What is it called? Something anesis or something like that. And you essentially, when you cast it, it costs 3 source points. It's a polymorph spell. It costs 3 source points. And whilst it's active for the next 3 turns, all other source spells no longer require source points. So you can literally, I can just infinitely cast Meteor Swarm or Epidemic of Fire. It is ridiculous. It is one of the best abilities in this game, by far. And then finally, I've just got Strength and Constitution for this one, with a little bit of Intelligence and a bunch of Memory. Yeah, I can't remember what it's called, Astrophoresis or something Phoresis. And its description is one step to becoming a god. But anyway, that's my setup. So let me jump back out. Ooh, there we go. Ending soon. There we go. So with that, thank you for joining me, everyone. It is amazing to have you come along, as I've said previously. But yeah, it is late. I've got some bits to do. Have a good one. Thank you, Asuli. And yes. Oh, yeah. Next time is Thursday. I've completely forgot that. Yeah. See you guys on Thursday if you want to join. It's been fantastic to have you. Have a good night. Goodbye.